Hello, beautiful souls. Becca here, and I am here today to share with you a little bit about Gene Key or Gate 44. And the purpose of sharing this information with you today is I really want to share some of the cosmic influences, the energetic influences that we're feeling potentially within our body, within our karmic relationships that we're having right now, and maybe some of the things that you're processing as far as doing the shadow work that you're doing. Today is, well, it's today is November 3rd, actually, but I'm doing this report or this cosmic energetic kind of report today, really to share the information that's coming up for our new moon in Scorpio. This is really, really, really powerful time for us right now to harness some of the energy that is bringing around things in our reality that are coming up for us to heal and clear. This is really an energy for us to catch places within our life, our relationships, our scenarios that are playing out in our kind of our world around us, and look at what's happening and find the places where we've maybe become disillusioned to the repetitive patterns in our life and the things that have we've just become accustomed to because we've become comfortable with it. That even though it's dysfunctional, we're comfortable with it, so we haven't really dealt with it. So this is some of the energy that's coming up. And specifically, I'm bringing this up because currently, as we move into the new moon in Scorpio coming on November 4th, what is going to be happening is we're not only in a time where our sun gate, so the transiting sun that is influencing every single one of us right now, is in the Gene Key or the gate of 44, but so is the new moon. Now, the new moon goes through a few different gates each day. It goes between two, it goes over through about 2.5 gates, 2 to 3 gates each day. So we can feel a huge influx of energy every single day as just the lunar influences or the emotional influences kind of make a wave through us. As the gates get activated by the transiting moon in our chart, what this means is that every 28 days, we really have a chance to be more aware and conscious of the cycles that we're going through. And we have the ability to begin to catch some of these cycles so that we can really honestly learn our pattern, learn how through a 28-day cycle, we begin to kind of have a natural flow of energy. Some days we feel more extroverted, like we're ready to go out and do things. Other days we might feel as though we're introverted or processing things. And this isn't random. There is so much that is available to us to begin to understand how we operate. So you yourself can begin to find your unique signatures and how you fit into the greater clock of the universe, if you will, because everything is operating within its own cycles and patterns and influences. And we could look at this as kind of understanding fractals. That we know that as a soul, we kind of fractal and move through experiences. And this is how we move through bloodlines. This is how we move through incarnations. And this is many times how we get karmic patterns. So, all of this is really just to start to share with you that right now, Gate 44 is giving us an incredible gift that we can pay attention to some of the patterns and the people, the relationships in our life, and really start to get honest with ourselves and ask ourselves, am I just tolerating or dealing with some of these patterns in my life because, well, that's just how it's always been? Or are we ready to start to transcend the lower shadow realms and vibrations and begin to become aware of what is not accelerating us in our path, our evolutionary path of growth, of spiritual growth, of transcendence within ourself into higher levels of consciousness. These higher levels of consciousness that we have the opportunity to step into are really our opportunity to become a spiritual adult, to realize that the world is not happening to us and we are not victims of it, that there are patterns upon patterns upon patterns upon patterns within our soul's incarnations that do not just happen in this lifetime. They are part of the infinite, of the greater pattern of the universe that we are a part of. We are not individuals, and this is part of waking up into our spiritual adulthood. We start to get out of the I and the me mentality, and we start to realize that we are part of a greater whole, and that we actually need to work together within this greater whole. And part of working together begins to allow us to realize that we are all co-creators of this amazing universe and reality that we are in. And therefore, the things that do not bring you joy and happiness in your life, this is where we get to take responsibility. And instead of pointing fingers or playing the blame game or the victim game, we start to really look back upon ourselves, upon where we are participating in perpetuating the fractals that are out of balance and out of divine right order. So let's really look at the gate 44. The gate 44 is incredibly powerful for us to really look at karmic patterns. It is a gate within our design. If you can think of it as part of the blueprint of your DNA, that each of these 64 gene keys that we look at have influence upon the 64 codons within your body that allow you to activate different memories and levels of knowing or knowledge within your DNA, within your evolutionary process of who you are. And that we could come to understand that a lot of our DNA has not been connected or activated. So part of our ascension process is reactivating our codes within ourselves, and not only reactivating, but repairing any of the aspects of our DNA that could be out of alignment, or what we like to call shadow work. So where we may be working in the shadow aspect of it, we start to repair it, heal it, elevate it into the gift that it is, and even into the city or the enlightened state of which it can express itself. So the 44th gene key is all about karmic relationships. So this is a gene key that is within the sign of Scorpio. So it has an innate ability to really go deep, deep, deep beyond the shadows, deep below the surface, to look at the places that most people don't want to look. Scorpio has that ability to be able to go deep into the places like taboo, the places other people don't want to go, and to actually feel comfortable looking there in order to find truth, the light, the enlightened place within there. But with it being karmic relationships and within the sign of Scorpio, Scorpio is also a place where there is holding a lot of deep wound and trauma for betrayal and being let down by loved ones in the past. So knowing that this is a deep, deep seated place that we are all being called to heal, that we are all being called to heal those deep wounds within ourselves so that we can transcend back into a place of co-creation. So within the gene key 44, the shadow side of this is interference. Now, interference is going to be what I want to kind of look at as on a very genetic level, interference, and also an auditory interference. Gene key 44 really works with the sense of smell, but really working on that deep level within ourselves of feeling it kind of in our bones, feeling the resonance of whether or not something is right or not right for us. So just, I want to read a little bit from the Gene Keys book to share a little bit of this, because the true fear underneath 44 is the fear of the past. Will the past come back again to bite me in the butt? You know, will the past come back again? And will I have to like deal with it all over again, or others will know what happened in the past? So it's about the genetics that we hold not only from our own incarnation, but through our bloodline, through our ancestors, through all of the genetics that we have been holding that have been like a fractal moving forward in time. So part of us really learning to do the shadow work is beginning to heal our ancestral bloodlines, to realize that a lot of the beliefs, the limitation, the blocks, the fears that we've been holding in our life aren't even ours. We inherited them. They were given to us. They were passed on to us. And it takes a very adept person on the path to begin to stop reacting to things in life anymore and begin to ask the questions. Where did this come from? Where did I learn this? Why is this happening to me in my life? Gene Key 44 is really being activated right now, not only by the solar influence in our life. So our sun, the sun is transiting over in it and activating it in our chart, but through the lunar, through our emotions. So it's coming not only through our identity, our ego, but also through the subconscious, the emotions are all being activated for us to look at our karmic patterns within our life and to begin to really ask ourselves, what is interfering in my life that is not allowing me to really break free and be the true being that I came here to be? And we know that by a discomfort that we hold within ourselves. Things just don't feel right. They don't. And for this Gene Key 44, it's about it not smelling right. So there is a very primal energy to it. I'm going to activate the line on here because it is coming from the splenic center, which is highly instinctual, highly intuitive. It is really just a knowing sense within, but this is coming from a deep sense of being able to smell on kind of a molecular level, being almost able to smell the DNA, smell the cellular communication, smell through the olfactory sense. And that our olfactory sense is one of the most powerful ways to really remember past lives. It's instantaneous. That is why aromatherapy is so powerful, because it instantaneously can break the blood-brain barrier so that it can access the neural processors within our mind, access the memory centers, and a smell that you may not even know holds a memory. You can smell it and it can instantly take you back to a memory, to a moment, to a time, to a feeling, to an emotion, right? So this is the power of this gate right now. That is how deep the Scorpio energy is in there. And remember, Scorpio is attuned to the planet Pluto. So our deep soul's mission and purpose. And it's also influenced with the eighth house, which has so much to do with how we relate with others, how we learn to go deeper into a relationship with others. So when we look at this, we can look at the term human fractal is an extension of this notion to human relationships, referring to the web of invisible patterns that bind certain groups of people together. So when we really look at our friend group or our family group, we can actually realize that there is energetic ties that may keep us bound to each other for multiple lifetimes, multiple life experiences. And this goes the same for people you may consider enemies in your life, because karmic ties are created through heightened emotion. And some of the people that we have the most heightened emotion with are the ones that we are actually clearing conflict with. So there is a lot of karmic patterns that are recreated over time and over time with people that in past lives we might have considered our enemies, so to speak, that may be actually your family members in this lifetime, so that they're very close to you, so you can learn to heal the relationship, learn to heal the polarity, the imbalance, so that it can actually come to a place of dissolving that heightened emotion. And we come to a place of sovereignty within ourselves where there's co-creatorship, no more blame, no more victimhood. We stop that polarized exchange of energy and we start to learn that we are all creating the scenarios simultaneously. Therefore, we're all responsible for every relationship in our life that we are having. 44 is also showing us that we will always draw towards those people through our genome, through our energy within, that teach us exactly what we need to know in order to evolve our awareness. So whether or not we want somebody in our life, if they are the most appropriate person energetically in our life to help us learn a lesson, it's as if they will just be magnetically drawn into our relationship. And honestly, that is why relationships are one of the best ways to evolve and grow, because if there is conflict, we get to learn how we are co-creating the conflict and learn what is inside of us that may be out of balance, or that we are seeking, or that we are feeling that we want to point fingers about. And we get to start to learn to take again that responsibility for ourselves. And so as we learn from each relationship in life over time, how to master the lessons each affords us, then the frequency of our entire energetic frequency of our holographic profile heightens in pitch, heightens in kind of the tone, the frequency, the sound, the vibration, in order to begin to attract other higher frequency fractals. This is how in many times we talk about that the more and more we start to heal ourselves, that certain people will leave our life and new people will enter into our life. There are these moments that come into our life, which are kind of like buffer zones, that I like to kind of think of them as that as we transcend certain patterns in our life, learn from them, grow from them, heal them. And as we move into higher frequency relationships, there's moments where sometimes a lot of people may move out of our life that just don't match. They're not a resonant match for us anymore. And sometimes there's that alone time in the middle where it feels like, oh, we've cleared everybody out. But when you sit in that silence for a moment, what happens is now you make room for your field to begin to ripple and make effect through the entire fractal of the universe. And now new higher vibrational people will start to come into your life, new friends, new relationships, new experiences that match where you are evolving within your life. So basically, it's also saying that if we don't learn from our relationships and we decide to end a relationship and jump into a new one, that eventually the pattern will come right back to us in this life through another person. So it's always best to really take every opportunity that we have and allow ourselves to learn from it so we don't have to repeat it again. Because how many times have we kind of heard the phrase, oh yeah, you know, they're with a new person, same person, different face, right? So it's just another way of saying, you know, it's like, yeah, they're in a new relationship, but the person has the exact same characteristics, attitude, same dynamic. So we don't want to just keep repeating that over and over and over. So as we begin to really acknowledge the gate 44, the gift of the gate 44 in there, we get to ask ourselves, honestly, how am I dealing with this? There's one way we deal with it sometimes, which is being repressive, which means, oh, and this is very Scorpio. It's like, oh, I got my feelings, you know, hurt. That relationship broke my heart. That situation didn't work out for me and I got screwed by it. It's the whole feeling of betrayal, of distrust, of who can I trust because I've been abandoned or people will hurt me. It's this feeling of distrustful. So the repressive nature is to have gone through something hurtful and then just to decide to close the doors and not deal with it ever again. I will never get in another relationship. I'll never commit to being in a partnership in a business ever again. I will never. You can fill in the blank. And that's the whole thing. It's kind of like door shut. And what that's doing is it's burying the wounds in the basement and repressing them. And when we do that, What's going to happen? Well, that pattern is still in our fractal, and it means that it is going to reciprocate itself again. If not in this lifetime, in another lifetime, it will just reciprocate itself. It has not been honored or healed. So the reactive nature would be to misjudge. So misjudging is about just completely kind of like blinders on and rolling through life full speed ahead and just continually choosing the same relationship over and over and over again by keep making the same mistakes in relationships. So it's really about kind of looking at things and becoming blind to them as to facing what they really are. And then allowing ourselves to be like, oh yeah, no, this one's better. This one's different. And then we find ourselves hurt all over again in the same way. And it's kind of a disassociation, if you will, to really just kind of be in this misjudging, not really wanting to be real and look below the surface. So when we begin to move into the gift of the gate 44, it's about teamwork. It's about working together. It's about realizing it's more than just us and that we are part of a co-creative relationship, right? So this is where we start to get into really tapping into the intuitive, instinctual nature of 44, which allows us to almost instantaneous like that, the tag phrase for the gate 44 as far as the instinct or the intuition of it is you can smell out a rat, so to speak, right? It's just, you don't know how you know, but there's something about a person that you know is off, and you'll never be able to sit and analytically, because this isn't connected to the mind. This isn't connected to the thought process. This is on a very basic molecular DNA level that you're instinctually, intuitively getting information, and you don't know how you know, you just know something's not right with this person. So it's really about when you are in close proximity, especially with a person, it's as if you can feel whether or not your cells are singing together, whether they're harmonizing, whether your fractal is working together. And when you can allow yourself to instinctually flow, you begin to feel who resonates and who doesn't, and how to create a team that starts to harmonize and work together. And this is about starting to trust ourselves. But the only way we can do that is if we do the shadow work to clear out the places within ourselves that are running from those ancestral or those karmic programs from the past, that are those broken, repeated patterns that are keeping us in dysfunctional relationships. When we start to clear those, now we realize we have an internal guidance system that just allows us to kind of harmoniously tune in around us to exactly who's correct for us, for how we can harmonize and work together as a team. So this is about really being able to sense and feel the true nature of others. And as this happens, this is where we get into the enlightened state or the city, which is synarchy, which is about dual rulership, about everyone having a rulership, about the harmony of an entire group vibrating, buzzing, working together as if we are kind of like a harmony of nature, like a school of fish or a swarm of bees or something, just the whole harmony of how there's instinctual communication between each other. They're not sitting and radio waving each other over a walkie-talkie on what to do next, left, right, left, right. It's a unified body. And this is where we really get into that frequency and that vibration of co-creatorship, that we are all completely being in this very open state in order to really, truly flow. Flow with source, flow back with the universe, to feel that we are part of a greater whole. And as we surrender to a greater whole, we realize that we are part of soul families and oversoul families and Christic avatar God families. And as we do that, we realize that we have all come from the tri-founder flame, the tri-founder wave that is emanating from the source frequency. And it's the solar rishi fields. And what's so important to know about this is that these solar rays, these solar founder rays this Rishik sun that is coming back into our universe, reactivating again, is the reason why so many more people are asking questions and actually doing the internal work right now. It's amazing. But right now, currently, while the sun is going through more activation, more solar flares, as we start to move into the eclipse season coming up at the end of the year here, as we start to feel the plasma waves of the new transformations and the new light codes coming into us, we're being able to open ourselves and hear the symphony of what is correct and what is not, and begin to align ourselves back again with this tri-founder wave and allow ourselves to really flow with the Trinity wave again of the source code. In short, this really means that the more and more we clear our subconscious, find the patterns, the karmic patterns of the past, do the clearing work, do the cleaning work. This gate 44 is an entire gift to allow ourselves to basically step off the karmic wheel, let go of the past so that we can be in the present, be in the now, be reunited again back with our true divinity, the higher elevated aspect that we are. And as we do that, there comes a moment where you can start to just allow yourself to align again with your higher self, align with your Christ avatar, God self, align again with the cosmic blueprint, the divine blueprint, and just let it flow and begin to find what resonates for you. I will tell you that as you connect with this frequency, it resonates at such a high vibration that you feel the compassion in your heart opening up. You feel the love in your heart opening up. It's as if that becomes the guide. There's no desire to want to judge or to put down, or to be a victim anymore, or to even perpetuate unhealthy relationships. There's such a pulse within this natural divinity to want to be in a harmonious, co-creative flow with others that it naturally starts to clear out the clutter, clear out the past, and allow ourselves to align again to our higher purpose. And the reason why we all chose to be here, to be the gift that we came here to be. So as you take this information, just know that this is something that is really elevated within our charts at this time. This is something that we can grow from, be a part of, allow it to influence our energy so that we can be more, we can create the communities, the co-creation, the connection, you know, the teamwork with each other. There's such a desire for us to not be alone. And this is really a gate about learning how to step out of the old and feel that we are not alone. We are not alone at all. So as this new moon in Scorpio is completely giving us this opportunity to really dig deep, to find the karmic ties that we're ready to let go of, to find the new seeds, the new frequencies in the future that we want to plant into our next 28-day cycle of who we are growing into. I just wanted to share this beautiful gate with you in order for you to be able to take it and see how it fits in your life right now. How can the beautiful energy that is affecting us and both the sun and the moon right now allow us to grow within, let go of the past, embrace the future, the truth, the emanescence that we are in the totality of this universe, that we in a true sense can become aligned again, that we are all one, that we are all parts of source, having physical experiences, getting to know, getting to experience, and getting to have this beautiful moment with each other right now, that right now, just right now, we're having this level of co-creation. So thank you so much for allowing me to share this with you. If you would ever like a more in-depth kind of look into your chart, your specific transits, or the energy that's influencing you so that you can start to learn your patterns, I would be so honored to be able to help you with that. Just please reach out to me. Happy new moon in Scorpio. Thank you so much.